Everyone, I'm Meghna. So in this class, I will discuss the chapter 14, that is semiconductor electronics. So chapter number 14, that is semiconductor electronics materials. Devices and simple circuits. So this chapter basically or more importantly discuss about the semiconductors. So what are semiconductors then? Semiconductors are the materials which has got conductivity in between the metals and the insulators. So the semiconductors are the materials which has got conductivity in between conductors and insulators. So this is the definition which you are learning from the class 7th or 8, 9, 10th. So I think you are quite clear with the definition semiconductor. So in today's class, I will try to cover few concepts like introduction to the chapter, and the second thing we are going to see is the difference between conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Next, we will try to understand what is energy band. The next thing, we will go for valence band and conduction band. Next is forbidden energy gap. So these are the few concepts that I'll discuss in today's class. Before that, so where are the semiconductors used? So these semiconductors are used in many electronic gadgets like mobile phone, laptops, and in space technology also these semiconductors are used. So these are the building blocks of all the electronic circuits that you come across. So for example, if you have ever seen the chip of the mobile phone, it consists of small black color device, that is diode. So this is diode, and there's one more device that is which has got three legs, that is transistor. So these two devices are semiconductor devices. This really perform the great many things, and they make the device very reliable. So from this it is clear the semiconductors are used in electronic gadgets like mobile, laptop, computers, and these are also used in different field. Like if you have seen the tube light, olden days tube light, they actually used to consume so much energy, and they used to produce the heat energy. So these are replaced by the semiconductor device known as LEDs. LED stand for light emitting diode. So these LEDs will take less amount of energy and will produce so much bright light. So these are again the semiconductor devices. So do you know how white LEDs are made? If not, the white LEDs are made by the combination of red, green and blue LEDs. So when you combine these three LEDs, it will give you the white LED. These LEDs are largely used across the world. So in many different places, these white LEDs, red LEDs, blue LEDs, green LEDs, all these LEDs are used, which consume very less amount of energy and can produce larger light. So next is CRT TV. So CRT stands for cathode ray tube. So these TVs are replaced by the LCD and LED TVs. LCD here stands for liquefied crystal display. So LED again is light emitting diode. So the CRTs are also replaced by the LCDs, very light slim LCD, whereas the cathode ray tubes were huge, which used to occupy so much space. Now the LCD TVs are very small and they are very thin, so you can keep wherever you want. So the next is the semiconductors are also used in solar panels. So solar panels, so the panels which are made, they are made with the silicon germanium. So when light falls on them, they will convert the light into electrical energy. So the semiconductors are used in various fields. They are reliable, they are cost effective. So why this semiconductors became so important, having the metals insulators, why these become important and why they are majorly used in many fields? Because there's two properties which make them very important. The first property is they can control the number of charge carriers. So charge carriers may be electrons and holes. So you will learn in detail about what are holes and electrons in the coming section. For now, you just understand the semiconductors can control the number of charge carriers that are there in the material. And the next property is these can give unidirectional current. So if you have a metal, say for example copper, if you give current, if this is a copper, if you give current, it goes from here and comes this side. So again, if you give current this side, it will come this side. So if you make a wire with semiconductor, So when you give the electricity here, since it follow only unidirection, so it can come only from this side. This it will not come from this side. So this makes it important to study. Next is, so this semiconductors were discovered in 1930. So in 1930s, the solid state semiconductors were discovered, in which the charge carriers can be varied with small intensity of heat, light or voltage. So by giving very small amount of heat or light or voltage, you can actually vary the number of charge carriers that are there in the semiconductors. So these semiconductors are, the advantages of these semiconductors are, they are very small in size. So if you see in mobile, I said diodes are used. So from this you can imagine what could be the size of the semiconductors, and no heating is required for this, and it can take very low voltage, and the semiconductor devices are long life devices, and they are again high reliable. So all these advantages again make the semiconductors important to study, or semiconductors important to understand. So next let us understand the classification of metals, insulators and semiconductors. So these three are classified based on the conductivity. So metals, so what are metals? Metals, these are the solids which have low resistivity or high conductivity. These are solids which have low resistivity or high conductivity. The range of resistivity for metals is, so rho is the symbol for resistivity. So range is, it is from 10 power minus 2 to 10 power minus 8 ohm meter. The resistivity of metals vary from 10 power minus 2 to 10 power minus 8 ohm meter, and 1 by rho will give you sigma, that is conductivity. Just change the sign, it is like 10 power 2 to 10 power 8 Simon meter. So the conductivity is just the inverse of resistivity, hence the value here is 10 power 2, here is 10 power minus 2. So now you can see the resistivity is so less when compared to the conductivity for materials like metals. And now let us see what is the resistivity range for insulators. So what are insulators? Insulators are the solids which have high electrical resistivity. Insulators are the solids which have high electrical resistivity. So what is the resistivity range then? It is 10^11 to 10^19 ohm meters. So now you can see it has got very high range. See here it is 10^-8, here it is 10^-19. So this insulator has got high resistivity when compared to metals. And what is conductivity? Conductivity is again very low, 10^-11 to 10^-19 Siemens meter. Next, let us understand what is semiconductors. Semiconductors are, these are solids which have electrical conductivity intermediate to metals and insulator. So the range of resistivity is 10^-5 to 10^6 ohm meter, and the range of conductivity is just opposite of that, 10^-6 Siemens meter. So what are the examples for metals then? So metals are, examples would be aluminium, copper, gold. So for insulators, examples are wood, diamond, for conductors, semiconductors, examples are silicon, which is denoted by Si, germanium, which is denoted by Ge. So this is the classification. Here we saw what are metals, insulators, semiconductors, and these are divided on the basis of resistivity and conductivity values. So next, so the values here given are not the constant or the exact values. The values may change, may vary. So these are not the constants. Sometimes the values may also exceed. So here the conductivity of insulator sometimes exceed, or sometimes it may also decrease the range. So now let us see the types of semiconductors. So there are basically two types. First one is elemental semiconductor. So example for elemental semiconductors are like silicon, germanium. So there's another one, it is compound semiconductor. So in compound semiconductor you have gallium arsenide, so indium phosphate, then CDS. So these are inorganic compound semiconductors. If you see anthracene, it is organic compound semiconductors, and there's one more, it is polyaniline. This is organic polymer. So these are the different types of semiconductor that you will come across in this chapter. In this chapter we basically use the elemental semiconductors. They are silicon and germanium. So we basically study how the motion of electrons are there in this silicon semiconductor, and what will happen if you join n-type semiconductor, p-type semiconductor, what is junction, that all things you will learn in this chapter. So that's all in this chapter or in this class. We learned the introduction to the chapter, then we learned what are metals, insulators, semiconductors, and then we also learned the types of semiconductors.